Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to In the Streets. Today I'm on a ball. Today I'm on a roll. Today I'm very comical. Today I'm very humorous because too much negative things has been going on in this little island, Jamaica. So I just want to do some video to kind of bring some highlight to the world, to let the world know that great artists are still here that can hold the fort and not hold it for slackness. The brother that you're seeing beside me is none other than Keith Shepherd. Now, Keith Shepherd is a master artist. I'm talking about with the paintbrush, a sign artist. And he's also a master dub poet. But Keith is has been a friend of mine. I've been a friend of my sister, Janet Sinclair, for many years. As a matter of fact, the day that Janet passed away, this was the guy that was driving Janet Sinclair when she actually passed away. All right, so you know how close of a friend he is to the family. Now, he has a famous song. You must have been hearing about this great group of youths by the name of No-Maddz. Everaldo Craver is one of the youth that is creating havoc in No-Maddz. And then you want to know who is also creating havoc? Sheldon Shepherd, which is the son of my next guest, Keith Shepherd. Keith Shepherd, welcome to In the Streets.
Yeah, man. Happy to be here.
Keith, I've known you for many years. I've seen you perform on numerous amount of shows. And I had the opportunity to actually call you up on a number of shows. Where this fantastic talent of, let's start with your first love, dub poetry, that is it. Where did that start?
Dub poetry started at Vauxhall, but the talent started in the Methodist Church.
In the Methodist Church?
The talent started in the Methodist Church.
Yes.
You had to be, you were motivated to perform, and I used to act in the plays in the church. They saw the talent and they promoted it.
Okay.
And so I got interested. So when I reached Vauxhall, I was seasoned in the stage already. But everything started at festival, JCDC, and Vauxhall in the preparation, because we started to prepare at Vauxhall. And the teacher who taught us, Miss Bogle and Miss Rodney and Miss Livingston, they were very strict and serious, you know. And we started with, I first year festival, bronze medal, although I wasn't supposed to go because I couldn't pronounce my H and my whatever correctly. It was like standard English.
Yes.
But
yes.
I went. I went because of my dramatic presentation. I love to open my eyes, whatever. They say it's dramatic, send him. They're not when you hear the language.
Yeah.
They see the action.
Yes.
Now the guy from England who said the same poem with me also got bronze. But his English was excellent, but he didn't have any action. I got bronze because I had the action to go.
So when you say you had the action and the eye, kind of demonstrate what it was like to win your first medal, your first bronze.
Here, the Forbes and Failing, I was so instrumental when they told me that I should look at the audience and not at the ceiling.
Yes, you were staring at the ceiling.
Yeah, I was in grade 7, man. You don't want to see nobody's face, you know. I just know I was supposed to say a poem.
Yes.
And I went and I stared at the ceiling, and that was it. And when at the end and they started to criticize, they said they're asking me kindly to look in the eyes of the people, and from that I start looking in the eyes of people and I'm performing.
So what was your first thing like? You remember it?
I don't, you know, that is one of the only poems I don't try to remember, like gutters down the face of a nasty street. I don't even want to go no further.
It was
a hungry child, but it was too depressing, and you know what? I think why I deal with poem this way is because I wanted to communicate with my peers. And I realized that they don't want to listen to like gutters down the face of a nasty street, ran small vein like tracing of tears to a hungry mouth. No, sir. They wanted to hear.
That was more like Shakespearean type
of thing. Yeah, they wanted to hear. And that was standard English. So the next year I entered dialects. And I did something like my first gold medal, that was the next year, which was Dread Song by Sandra Y. I am on dread and my eyes are red. I am strong and I shall live for long. I smoke my spliff and my locks are stiff. I keep my locks clean cause I love my queen. I love the eye color ice green and gold cause it free my soul. I don't fear no ballad. I don't fear no bad man. I don't fear no soul man because what? I'm on dread. I just said, what? And I had a false wig that did it. Everybody thought I was dread at the end, and I got gold. It was the first gold medal. And that was written by someone else. And I went to national finals and I got nothing. Okay. The next year I did Natty Get a Bly. I sight the roadblock and I step on the brakes. Mm-hmm. Babylon come forward like him want die for quick. Come mm-hmm. out of the car, boy, with a knotty head. I drive teeth in the car and I chop out your dread. Diamond just easy. Diamond just cool. Him say what a search I submit to the rule. Him search I up, him can't find nothing. Him start cuss and spear, say what do I stop?
Take off your shoes, boy. Take off your socks. If I did not be raised, I'd just trim your dirty locks.
Oh, yeah, go, boy. Just go in on the jeep. No feel no way tonight, cause I jail you asleep. Diamond just easy. I didn't move. His stupidity I was determined to prove. I asked, why do they then rage? Imagine a vain thing. I deal with truth and right. I ought the son of a king. I step far when evil draw near. I deal with love. I have nothing to fear.
Him look for me good and him nod him head. Him take time, move the barrier and say, go true dread. Next goal, next national award.
Yes.
No national award.
Mm.
Guess why?
Mm-hmm.
The piece wasn't original. I did not write them.
Oh.
So the most of the marks went for performance and what have you. But most of the marks, the higher mark was for originality.
So those two sounds that we just heard, wasn't those two
written
by somebody else.
Right.
But you still won gold anyway.
Yeah, right.
All right. So the next one though, what happened after that?
A young lady met me on the road and said, a student of Holy Trinity, and said, her name is Paula, yeah, and said, Shepherd, you can write a poem for me, because I must hear about Little Cool, I'm a festival, and I think I'm a great writer.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a great poet, but as a writer at that time, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I said, the teacher gave me a title one Saturday morning on King Street. I said, all right, and I wrote it, and I gave her, and about 3 weeks after she came back, I said, we get A? Someone said, if she get A for it, maybe I can hit a festival with it.
Mm-hmm.
And win. And I did, and that was my first national award.
What was
the man on King Street. But it's a strong poem, it's a long poem. I can't
say. No, just give me one piece here. We just want to hear your original thing.
And No-Maddz has it, and it's recording it now. They're doing it in their own unique way, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's all bad. It says, me just a walk in the heat. Me just a walk in a the heat. One Saturday morning pan King Street. Say one Saturday morning pan King Street. Me hear somebody ball out with teeth. And then me hear the sounds of rushing feet. And when me look it was a thief. The people them a beat. One Saturday morning pan King Street. You should have seen it. Yeah man, you should have seen it. Yeah man, we're due to all me the deaf and hiss. We couldn't stay for help them the youth face. So me walk little more near time store. Me see one man sit down at the door with him hand outstretched. No me no know whether him blind or him deaf. But that no nothing yet. Cause I bet you never tell me who I saw right beside him. I bet you never tell me who I saw. One blind man just a play up him saw. Say mama see, mama saw, mama what who I saw. You should have seen the blind man just a play up him saw. One Saturday morning, on King Street, you should have seen it. Yeah man. You could have seen it. Yeah man. Then coming up the road, a man burdened with load. Look like him have him clothes in the load. Because he make it as if they him born. Yes, he mad. This a man a most mad. Make it as if they him born. People start look upon him with scorn. Mother start cover up them pickney eye. Our fathers start going like them shy. One Saturday morning, on King Street, should I see it?
Yeah, man.
Goal!
Should I see it? Yeah, man.
So, goal, that was your original piece that you actually got goal with. And then the streaks of medal just continued. Today, because when I started the show, I wasn't sure of the amount of gold. How much gold medals do you think you have in your house? The last time you counted, how much was it?
I don't keep track of that, you know.
Over 10?
Over how much national awards do I have? Four? Well, it was consecutive, five. stop them. But gold medal was like, because what actually at my usually get gold also with the choirs from the school, and each shift they are into the boys choir and a mixed choir, and both choirs every year got gold.
Okay.
So at the end of the time, we're going home about 7 medals for 1 year.
For 1 year, yeah. So, and is it the 20s?
I entered standard English also, although I said it wasn't helping in communication. So I think why I do dub poetry is because, and I might stop calling it dub poetry, I call myself a poet performer.
A poet performer.
I was advised to do it because they say what actually happens is that I also can do dialect and I can do Martin Luther King speech. And I can, so I should just stop stereotyping to dumb poet and say I'm a poet performer. I'll perform any poem.
But you know, I've been listening to all of your work, and your work are outstanding, ladies and gentlemen. I must have to tell you. He has been doing it for many years, and his son, Sheldon Shepherd, has taken the baton and is
great.
And
Rashim Shepherd has entered a number of pieces.
Mm-hmm.
And for this year, he told me that about 4 or 5 pieces got gold from his students. He teach at Arden Prep and Franklin Town Church of God, Infant School, and Mavisville.
So, what made Sheldon, right? Is he your eldest?
He's your eldest son.
What made Sheldon? I mean, they say like father, like son, but what kind of draw him into it?
Well, he said his mother told him to watch his father and do everything he does except drinking. And he'd be okay. And pick something that he likes from me and specialize in it, because I could do a lot of things for a certain level.
Yes.
And he did that.
He's an artist too
with charcoal and what have you.
Wow.
But him don't do it. Him say no arts.
Spend too much time,
on his entertainment, and you want to spread thinly, but I don't really call it. I just feel that there's a time for everything, and there's a time to paint, and there's a time for poetry.
And painting does a lot for your mind to relax. I do a little painting myself.
So this year, Body Poet is planning. It is already online for an exhibition at his house. It's either Sunday morning or Saturday morning for the 4 artists from the veranda. Myself, I am one of the artists. And our work will be on display, an exhibition, but we'll hear more about that because it will be advertised properly.
Okay.
And so the date and time, it should be in August though.
I
can go and see 10 pieces of my work.
But I've listened to a lot of your work, like I said, and one of my favorite, ladies and gentlemen, because as a young man growing up, I told you many times that I grew up extremely poor, and my father was always trying to find a place for us to live. Even though my grandmother owned many acres of land, as I told you in previous videos. But for some of my father couldn't have a moan house, you know what I mean? And this piece, an excerpt from this piece, My Own House for Living Now, written by Keith Shepherd and performed by the legendary Keith Shepherd. See it, you know. Why you write that song, first of all? You never want to own house till that
used to. I don't own it still, but we're... I used to have a lot of problems with landlord. I used to say things that I can't believe, you know.
Like some of the things I'm like, what? Like one of.
It's in the poem. The poem can explain it.
All right.
So this, they can't go wrong, because most of this poem is experience, live and direct.
Okay. Here it is.
But life funny, eh? Look how somehow we dress up. And we don't live nowhere. I am no political activist. I'm only a man with some conscious lyrics. No, hear this. Me say me want a house to live in. Yes sir, me own a house to live in. What me say? Me want a house to live in. Yes sir, me own a house to live in. And a little bit of save, me save 10 cents from every dollar. And a little bit of work, me work for help to build Jamaica. You promise me a house just before you go in a power. So nobody play gin along guan like you know. Remember, nobody tell me about no economic pressure. Cause anything you are feel, we are feeling. What's that? Me want a house to live in. Yes, sir. Me own house to live in. Yes, sir. Hey, come let me tell you about the rent house I'm living in. Just the other day, me did invite my friend them over. Should I see we sitting down on the veranda talking roots, reality, and culture? Landlord come out with him, yeah, full of fire about him rent me 2 rooms. I never rent me no veranda. But see, the situation, I'm not ready for the stress. You know, say, liberty come to carelessness. The rent house business can't take no more. When you live in a rent house, you're too insecure. You don't have to do landlord. Nothing for them put you out a door. Then them fix them window. Paint them wall. And when you hear the new rent, my God, you want ball. My house
to live in that. Yes, sir.
My whole house to live in that. Yes, sir. Me even landlord, I tell him friend when he is sweet when he put me and my family pan the street if he burn down the house, make him feel enough eat. But then the better man said, sure, the bother do it.
Yes, sir.
My own house to live in. Yes, sir. The other day, me do my work and take long if you get my pay, so me never get to pay the rent pan the due day. Boom, 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 knocking upon the door. I said to myself, I must land on that for sure. Boom, 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 the man knocked some more. I went outside, I said, morning, Mr. D. He turned to me and said, no one a morning from me. All he wants is him rent money. I said, this month I'm going to be a little late. He said, see a man no bother test me faith. Mm-hmm. So said. So done, but the day I pay the rent, the next day the notice come. My house living there. Yes, sir.
My own house living there.
Yes, sir. A house I make one. The size don't really matter. But me no want a full cup, no want something much bigger. Also me want must have strong roof. Also me want must be Gilbert proof. The wall of me house not for easy to shake. The house of me want must can't turn earthquake. And a little bit of save me 15 cents from every dollar. And a little bit of what my work for help to build Jamaica. You already promised me one house before you're going to power. So nobody play a genial one like you no member. Nobody tell me about no economic pressure. Cause anything you are feeling, we are feeling. Oh, sir! My house to live in, huh? Yeah. Yes, sir! Yeah, man, I was living on that.
What a
straight and direct.
Yes, that was Keith Shepherd, ladies and gentlemen. The sound that he has used on many times, many shows that I've had the opportunity to speak with him on. And it's just pandemonium. So what are you doing now, 2017? You're working on your album. I know you have plans to travel. What can your audience, you have a... how can you be contacted?
We're releasing my book this year. Also.
You're releasing a book?
Yeah.
And let's not forget, ladies and gentlemen, he's an accomplished actor. Tell him couple of the movies that
you've done. Well, I can look through Killing Back for the webpage. I used to say son and Belly Pain. I starred and actor. I wrote, star and act those two productions.
Wow.
Son. Now that I'm going to give my son, because he's very good. Mm-hmm. Rashim. He's a very good producer. He did a play the other day, Undercover Craziness, and it was nominated for Actor Boy Award for Best Comedy. So he's waiting now to see who's going to beat him.
So you're still open now for work and stuff. Suppose somebody wants you in Africa, England, the Caribbean. How can you be contacted?
I am always open for work because I have a message. And I'm not gone yet.
You have a number that you can share with the world just in case they want to call you.
530-5824 or shepherdkeith@hotmail.com.
Okay.
shepherdkeith@hotmail.com.
What, me not going in Instagram yet?
No, you know, that just...
You know, they're on Twitter.
I have never made any... I just get the phone that can do that, you know.
Okay,
I'm only on WhatsApp now, that same number is a WhatsApp number. 530-5824. I don't go on Instagram yet. I don't go on Twitter yet. You know, because I hear that certain people is on Twitter, you know. I don't really want to go on there. Maybe I said something that offend them and I'm barred from the U.S. I don't want to be barred from the U.S.
So let me ask you a question.
I said, tell you the truth, they're the one that are just starting to write.
Uh-huh. Oh, to the United States President?
You don't write it. I don't call it any name. I don't call it. But no wrong if I suffer upon a rump. Following the footsteps of President Trump. Now him say one, it say, yeah, I'll grab them in the meow. Probably in the arrow. What kind of thing is, what really about, what is they about? Why him really say, grab them in the meow. Grab them in the meow. When it finish, I'll let you hear it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know, but Donald Trump is not one of the most liked president. I personally like Donald Trump. I think any person that loves his country, you know, I have to give him that level of respect. I'm not living in the United States, so I don't know the political part of what is happening. I'm not a political analyst anyway. I'm just a true-bred Jamaican who love my country. And that's why we're taking this opportunity now to speak to a lot of Jamaicans who are in the United States and England and Canada to start sending home some money from my yard and to people who can take care of your money, because we have a lot of unscrupulous people. You know what I mean?
To the world, we're saying beg your peace.
Yeah, man, and peace we want.
No, man, peace of what you're eating. I mean, it's time you start all this fussing and fighting. Time we start uniting. Beg your peace.
Beg your peace. But yeah, you say you have something for that?
No, it, man, I never want him beg your peace,
you
know?
Yeah.
We don't go into the detail. Let's beg your peace.
Let's beg your peace.
You tell a girl that you get nervous.
If you tell a girl to beg your peace.
Beg your peace. But you know, I just have no mean peace of what you're eating. I mean, it's time we start uniting. Beg your peace. P-E-A-C-E. Beg your peace. P-I-E-C-E. Beg your peace.
So in part, you know, I know you're a very busy person. We kind of catch up with the superstar. Who you want to shout out to? Who you want to give a big hail up to you, that has helped your career along the line and into the future?
Healing up is a you see, all of a virgin them, you know, them know themselves, you know, locally and internationally, you know. So Douglas, Dougie. You have people who are inspirational, you know, a big stone who always encourage you, you know.
Give thanks.
And we don't give up, you know, because if it wasn't for, there's a little saying that says certain friends, you will know who your friends are. Because if you go to a friend and say, you want to buy a car, you know, and the first thing he tell you is, you can't take care of a car, you can't think that, not a good friend. But your friend's supposed to say, what type of car you want
to buy? Yeah, exactly. How soon do I get it?
Yeah, and you don't think that's the right one.
And we can make a spin it up. And we can make a spin it up.
Once they encourage you, you say you want to do a book, and they encourage you to do the book. But they say, what you have the book for? Maybe you don't spell that right. Maybe when they find all the negatives, it's not a good friend.
Not a good friend.
They must work on the positive energy that you are bringing to them and enhance it.
And enhance it.
Yeah.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Keith Shepherd. Master poet, dub poet,
poetical performance. My son's mothers and all of them, you know?
Yeah, you are yelling up
Jennifer, Celine, people who I'm with now, like V, you know, very serious woman, you know?
Yeah, big up yourself, V.
Yeah, you know, enough respect and keep on keeping on, you know?
Keep on keeping on.
Yeah, my mother was not well. I went to look for her this year. I went to be in Georgia this year. I have to be. Okay. Sky's the limit for me. I've never tried to leave, but I have to be there.
Okay, so she now resides in Georgia?
Right, my mom and my sister is in Georgia. Maxine. Hyacinth, you know?
Okay.
Mom and sister lives in Georgia. Nikki, who lives in England. Nadine out here, Cheryl, Buzz. Just lost my eldest brother, Lloyd, and he just died two Saturdays ago.
Wow.
You know,
wow.
So my father was still alive at 94 and well, you know?
Wow.
Simeon Shepherd.
Yeah.
The man who said, choose one of them. You can't do all of them. You can't smoke, drink, or gamble. Choose one of them. So I left the smoking and the gambling for a while, you know?
Yeah.
But I've left it for a good while because, you know?
So there, much,
yeah, you have to pick and choose,
yeah? So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Here we have come to the finale of a very interesting conversation, myself and Keith Shepherd. Look for him, he's all over the place. His movie, son, and others. And of course, his son, Sheldon Shepherd from No-Maddz, is doing great work. Big up yourself, Sheldon. I know Sheldon from Sheldon was a young man and he has blossomed into a superstar now. So I can only say more powers to the group. I'm a friend, I met him in Gimme Me Bit. I saw the place name a country. Gimme Me Bit. I had the opportunity to work in the stage with Ballad at the time, Elvrad Lecreary. And boy, me and him, we had fun in that place then. Don't be a Rasta now. So, Elvraldo, Rastafari. Sheldon, Rastafari. Okay, everybody in that up now. No mass to the world. Let's look out for that group. They're tough. A big stone. So. Give thanks for watching. And then, guess what? If you don't like my video, you know, I'm not big enough to subscribe, you know, man. Can't bother with the big thing, you know. if my video alright and the thing are going good, subscribe to the thing, man. Like the thing, man. If you want to share it with a friend, them share it with a friend, them and you don't want to share it. Share it to them and you don't want to share it. See? Because from the work good, you don't want to share it. Just share it to another friend, man. Yeah? And stay tuned. Hit the bell, at the labor right bell. Hit the bell if you want to hear more from Big Stone. Aye, aye, aye.
Prosperity.